الحمد لله واحد رضيت بالله ربا وبالاسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ان الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sharrul umuri muhdathatuha. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. Wa kullu muhdathatin bid'ah. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. Wa kullu bid'atin dalalah. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. Wa kullu dalalatin fi an-nar. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. Thumma amma ba'd. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala laid down certain rites, etiquettes, manners, and He obligated them on the Muslims for them to have, especially towards one another. So these are rites and behaviors that we owe one another as brothers and as sisters in faith. Therefore, the one who does them honors the right of their Muslim brother and sister, honors those rights and fulfills them, and maintains the etiquettes that come with them. Then this person pleases Allah by following Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa. Indeed, the believers are nothing but brothers and sisters to one another. So these etiquettes and rites are many, and over the next few weeks we'll cover them to remind ourselves of the rites that just because we and they say la ilaha illallah, those rites over us are in place. And the first of them is nothing more than the salam, the greeting with one another, that we should greet the other Muslims not with hello, hi, what's up, khudafiz, marhaba, whatever else it may be. But the greeting of Islam for all the Muslims is assalamu alaykum, or assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, or assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And it is done in this way to wish peace and mercy and the blessings of Allah upon your brother or sister in faith. And you shake their hand, and the other Muslim will reply to you, and it becomes obligatory when you greet someone with this salam, that they respond to you with at least the same response, if not more. كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّ بِأَحْسَنِ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا. The statement of Allah in Surah An-Nisa, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, and when you are greeted with a greeting, return the greeting with what is better, or at least with what is equal. So if somebody says to you, assalamu alaykum, you must respond with the minimum of wa alaykum assalam, but it is better that you add wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Even if someone responds with assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, because of this ayah, he said, you should respond by adding wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and adding wa maghfiratuh, and the forgiveness of Allah, may the forgiveness of Allah be upon you. Just to fulfill this ayah of always responding with something which is better. وَقَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يُسَلِّمُ الرَّاكِبْ عَلَى الْمَاشِي وَالْمَاشِي عَلَى الْقَاعِدْ وَيُسَلِّمُ الْقَلِيلِ عَلَى الْكَثِيرِ. رواه بخاري ومسلم. And our Prophet ﷺ, he guided us in this in many ahadith. In this one to mention that the one who is riding on something and he comes across people who are walking, the riding one should greet the one who is walking. The ones who are walking and standing should greet the one who is sitting. And a smaller group should always greet the larger group. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ And this is a hadith from Abu Huraira in the Sahih of Imam Muslim. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَا تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تُحَابُوا وَلَا أَوَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ أَفْشُوا السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ رواه مسلم. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, by the one in whose hand is my soul, you will not enter Jannah until you believe. And you will not believe until you love for your brother and sister what you love for yourself. And until you love one another. And may I inform you of something that if you do, you will love one another and it will increase the love between you and one another. He said, promote the greeting of Islam amongst you. Use this tahiyyat al-Islam, assalamu alaykum, and the likes of it with one another, because this will increase the love that we should have for one another as brothers and sisters in faith. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وتقرأ السلام على من عرفت وما ومن لم تعرف رواه بخاري ومسلم. And our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told us that we should greet one another, greet the people who you know, and you should also greet the people from Islam that you do not know. And we have gotten into this mode or this habit where you will come across many people who you know they are Muslim without a doubt, but because you don't know them personally, you don't greet them with the proper salam. And you only greet the ones whom you know or who you have a relationship with. And this is an error, because it was a command from our Prophet ﷺ to spread the greeting of Islam to those we know and those we do not know. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَا مِن مُسْلِمَيْنِ يَلْتَقِيَانِ فَيَتَصَافَحَانِ إِلَّا غُفِرَ لَهُمَا قَبْلَ أَن يَتَفَرَّقَ رواه أبو داود وحسنه الألباني. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, there are no two Muslims who meet and greet one another with the tahiyyah of Islam and shake each other's hand except that they are going to be forgiven for their sins, their minor sins, before they depart from one another. And Shaykh al-Albani, he graded this as hasan or sahih li ghayrihi. The sins that we do, the minor ones that we don't even take for granted, that we don't even think about or make istighfar for, they can be forgiven just by this simple greeting and meeting with a kindness and with goodness towards your Muslim brother or your Muslim sister, yani for the sisters with the sisters and the brothers with the brothers in terms of the shaking, obviously. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man bada'a bil kalami qabla as-salam, fala tujibuhu hatta yabda' bis-salam." So pay attention to this hadith in the collection of a hadith from At-Tabarani. And Shaykh al-Albani, hassanahu, he graded it as hasan. The Prophet ﷺ said, if someone begins speaking to you, if a Muslim begins speaking to you before they give you salams, then do not even respond to them until they greet you with the salam. So this hadith clearly exacerbates the point that we should always begin our greetings with one another with this salam. And you've even seen it with people who are not the best of acquaintances or friends, not the best of feelings between one another. And this salam acts like an icebreaker. It kind of lets things down. So we should always use this. Now returning that greeting, we should know it is obligatory if it's given to you. You must respond if someone greets you directly. But if there is a group and someone walks in and says, assalamu alaikum, it becomes a fard kifaya, a communal obligation. If some people respond, then the sin is lifted off you if you don't respond. But without a doubt, because of the rights of the Muslim on the Muslim, it is better that everyone who hears the salam from his brother, they respond to it with wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, or that which is better than what they greeted you with. So this salams to one another, this is a right of a Muslim upon another Muslim. And this is a right and an etiquette that we must establish and not let culture overtake how we put this into practice. The second one, from the rights and the etiquettes of the Muslim over the Muslim, is that if the Muslim sneezes, وَحَمِدَ اللَّهِ, and he praises Allah, then one must respond by saying, يَرْحَمَكَ اللَّهِ. One must respond by saying, may Allah have mercy upon you. Allah's Messenger ﷺ, he said, إِذَا عَطَسَ أَحَدَكُمْ فَلْيَقُلْ أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَلْيَقُلْ لَهُ أَخُوهُ أَوْ صَاحِبَهُ يَرْحَمَكُ اللَّهِ فَإِذَا قَالَ لَهُ يَرْحَمَكُ اللَّهِ فَلْيَقُلْ لَهُ يَهْدِيكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيُصْلِحْ بَالَكُمْ رواه البخاري. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he taught us the etiquette with this sneezing, saying if one of you sneezes, then his brother should say to him, may Allah have mercy on you, يَرْحَمَكُ اللَّهِ. And if his brother says, may Allah have mercy on you, then he should say back to him, may Allah guide you and set your affairs aright. According to the Shafi'iyah, to Imam Shafi'i in his madhab, it is a sunnah to respond to this. But according to Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad, and their madhahib, may Allah have mercy on them, they said it's obligatory, a fard ayn, for anybody who hears someone say Alhamdulillah when they sneeze, that you respond with Yarhamakallah, for the one who does this. And this is without a doubt the clearer and safer view. So I remind you, because daily we hear brothers who sneeze or sisters who sneeze, and there is no saying of Alhamdulillah. So this is the first thing. This is the etiquette of the Muslim, that when they sneeze, they say Alhamdulillah out loud. You say it out loud. Even if you're out and about, even if you're in a marketplace, you don't have to yell it. But you should say it where your lips move and there's some at least whisper off of your lips. The reason why some of those madhahib took it as obligatory was because of the hadith from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, where he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْعَاطِسِ وَيَقْرُهُ التَّثَاؤُبُ فَإِذَا عَطَسَ فَحَمِدَ اللَّهِ فَحَقٌ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ سَمِعَهُ أَنْ يُشَمِّتْهُ وَأَمَّا التَّثَاؤُبُ فَإِنَّمَا هُوَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ فَلْيَرُدُّهُ مَا اسْتَطَاعَ فَإِذَا قَالَ هَا ضَحِكَ مِنْهُ الشَّيْطَانِ رواه البخاري. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us in this hadith the etiquette of the one who sneezes and the one who yawns. He said that Allah Azza wa Jal, He likes the one who sneezes, because you end up praising Allah. But He dislikes the one who yawns. He dislikes yawning, the practice of yawning. So if somebody sneezes and praises Allah, and you hear them say Alhamdulillah, it is obligatory on every Muslim who hears him say Alhamdulillah that he says Yarhamakallah. It's obligatory. It's obligatory. So you must say it. No matter where you may be, you must say this. Of course, during Jum'ah, this prescription to not speak when the Imam is speaking, this stuff is left alone from you, inshallah, and not a sin upon you if you don't say it, because you should be listening to the khutbah and the dhikr. It's obligatory on every Muslim who heard him say it. And you must say to him, Yarhamakullah. So, as regards to the yawning, when one yawns, it is from shaitan, it is from Satan. So one must try their best to restrict the yawn, to cover their mouth, to cover it with their hand or their cloth or their shirt or whatever it may be, and to not make the noise. For the one who makes the noise, who makes that noise when they yawn, shaitan or Satan will laugh at him. So these are some etiquettes that we owe one another as brothers and sisters in Islam, and some etiquettes with respect to yawning as well that we mention and remind you with. أَقُولُ قَالِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ إِدْعُ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبُكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. My dear brothers in Islam, as Muslims, yes, we have the rights to our families and they have rights over us. Yes, we have the rights to our neighbors and they have rights over us. Yes, we have a right to even animals and they have rights over us. But to your brother and sister in Islam, there is a set of rights that if we do not put them into practice, we are sinning. And Allah will not be pleased with us. We mentioned the one who gives the salam, that it is obligatory to respond to that salam that your brother and sister gives you. وَرُدُّ بِأَحْسَنِ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا. And you should respond with what is better than it, or the least, to respond with what they met you with. And we mentioned, if you hear someone say Alhamdulillah when they sneeze, you should say to them Yarhamakullah. And this is obligatory on anyone who hears the person say Alhamdulillah. We get to a third point, which we'll finish with, and we'll go over these over the next week, inshallah, that you should visit your brother when they fall ill, and you should ask Allah to cure him. And this is based on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, حَقُّ الْمُسْلِمْ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمْ خَمْسِ, that the rights of the Muslim upon the Muslim are five. رَدُّ السَّلَامِ وعيادة المريض واتباع الجنائز وإجابة الدعوة وتشميت العاطس رواه بخاري ومسلم. So our Prophet ﷺ told us in this hadith that the rights of the Muslim upon every other Muslim is five. That you reply to their greeting if they greet you. You can't, no matter, even if you don't like them, if they say salamu alaykum to you, you must at least say wa alaykum as-salam. That you visit the one who is ill. And we're going to explain whether everyone has to go visit him or her, or just a few people. that you follow the funeral procession to the janazah, and we'll get more into that next week, responding to the one who invites you, and to respond to the person who says Alhamdulillah, and you hear them when they sneeze. And this hadith is Bukhari and Muslim. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him, he said, this is a fard kifaya, that if somebody is sick, that as long as some people go visit him from the community, from the brothers, from the Muslims, then the sin is lifted on those who don't go. So not all of us need to go and bombard a person who is ill, but we should make sure that someone from the community is going and visiting them and relaying the greetings and the well wishes, and you should make dua for Allah to cure them. And if they do so, then you not visiting them, the sin is lifted upon you. But we must be careful, especially in these times with coronavirus. Obviously, if there's a harm to you because the person is so sick, you don't go. But Alhamdulillah, now you can call them, you can send a text message, you can send a message via many routes. So inshallah, we should put this into play. When our brother or sister is sick, that we relay some type of greeting to them and ask Allah to cure them. Al-Bara ibn Azib radiallahu anhu, he said, أَمَرْنَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ بِعِيَادَةِ الْمَرِيدِ وَاتِّبَاعِ الْجَنَائِزِ وَتَشْمِيتِ الْعَاطِسِ وَإِبْرَارِ الْمُقْسِمِ وَنَصْرِ الْمَظْلُومِ وَإِجَابَةِ الدَّعْوَةِ وَإِفْشَاءِ السَّلَامِ رواه البخاري. To further reiterate this, another hadith, Al-Bara' ibn Azib, he said, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he commanded us, he ordered us to visit the one who is sick, to follow the janazah, to respond to the one who sneezed and said Alhamdulillah, to fulfill the oath to the one you made an oath to help the one who is oppressed, to respond to the one who invites you, and to spread the salutations amongst one another. Aisha radiallahu anha, she stated that the Prophet ﷺ, he would visit one of his family members when they were sick, and he would wipe them with his right hand and say, Allahumma rabbin nas, adhhab al-ba's, ashfi anta shafi, la shifa'a illa shifa'uk, shifa'an la yugadiru saqama. Ruwah al-Bukhari. Aisha, she narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he'd visit one of his family members when he was sick, he would wipe them with his right hand and say, O Allah, the Lord of mankind, remove the harm, cure them, for you are the one who cures, and there is no cure except your cure, a cure that leaves no disease. We know that hadith of visiting this one, the virtues, just to mention them quickly before we end, that the one who goes to visit his sick Muslim brother or sister, right? And with the sisters, of course, for the brothers, you have to take certain precautions. If they're not mahram, you can send your wife and the likes of this. But the one who goes in the morning, 70,000 angels make dua for Allah to bless you and forgive you until the evening. And if you go visit your sick brother or sister in the evening, again, if it's safe for you, then 70,000 angels make dua in the evening all the way till the morning that Allah blesses you and forgives you. One of the other ones we say, and we'll end with it, that when you see your brother or sister sick, you say, you can say certain ad'iyah, but you should always go back to what is in the Quran and the Sunnah. Always go back to what is in the Quran and the Sunnah. And do it the way it was mentioned, not these other exaggerated ways, where someone will go next to them and read this surah 5 times, this surah 100 times, this dua 10 times. We have to stick with what we have revealed in the sunnah, because it is the best of ways and the best of guidance. One of the dua the Prophet ﷺ used to say 7 times to the one who was sick, أسأل الله العظيم, I ask Allah the Almighty and the Great, رب العرش العظيم, the Lord of the Magnificent Throne, and يشفيك, that he cures you. And this was mentioned that he said it 7 times. So we don't need any other nonsense of things to say a number of times if it's not mentioned with proof, authentic proof, from the words and the mouth of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah make us of those who implement these rites. We could discuss 3. Between now and next week, do not slip on 1. Giving the salams and returning the salams to your brothers and sisters in Islam. If you hear someone sneeze, you make sure, you teach them if they don't know to say Alhamdulillah. And if they say Alhamdulillah, you say Yarhamakullah. And thirdly, that if there is someone who is ill, to at least check on them if it's not safe to see them. But if they can be visited for some reason, that you do so, especially in these times, with caution. And this lifts the sin of those who cannot go and see them. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta samii'un qareebun mujeebud da'awat. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.